for us to release it, it's been something that I feel like we as a family felt that it was the right thing, and we're so happy and excited that it's coming out. He was an awesome older brother. I think we had a lot of fun together.
He was fun, but he was also, he had that creative side to him.
He just had an adventurous spirit.
Mum encouraged us all to sort of take up an instrument.
I think we all knew that Shim was probably the most talented. Shim's primary instrument was a saxophone, but then one day he came home and started playing the guitar, just out of the blue, never been taught.
I know for myself I had to work, you know, to learn the guitar, but he just had a natural ear.
He was just musically gifted. I remember Mum telling us a story that she came home one day and he was like, I think I can write music, like I think I can create. He'd never really written before then, and I do remember him realising that what he was creating was probably something that people would really enjoy. And that year after school he spent writing and recording.
He finished the songs to some degree and had always planned to go travelling. He went all over Europe. He went back to Poland where our father is from, and we've still got family over there. And he also went over to Africa too. Weather keeps on changing, but the sky's still there. Lots of love to the front and bring me like a flame.
Whilst Shim was actually overseas, Dad sent in in Shimon's demo CD to EMI.
I definitely remember hearing Shimon's CD when it came through the post. I didn't know if it was a 40-year-old man playing 70s folk or if it was a brand new artist. It was just something really incredible.
There was so much beauty in those original tracks that kind of just, you know, really made us go, what the hell's going on here? Who is this?
To have someone in the industry interested in what you're doing and what you're creating is, I guess, every muso's dream.
We'd gone through a process of working on this, what is the Tiger Sap record. Over the course of 12 months, we'd gone back and forth, and every time I heard something new, I was like blown away. I was so excited about what this record was going to be. You know, those conversations were ongoing until a point where on our next visit to Newcastle, he wasn't sure what he wanted to do with the record.
Music took a little bit of a backseat when his health decreased. I think he was just never well enough to, I suppose, concentrate to complete songs like he was doing prior to that. His depressive state disconnected him from doing what he loved, and the pain became too much for him in the end.
From when Shim passed away, the guys at the label approached us saying that they had an album's worth of material. We're doing this for him, and we're doing this as best as we can to honour him.
He would have loved to have been here and released his songs for everyone.
This body of work is something incredibly special. He played every single note on this recording. He creates another dimension which you slowly fall into.
Music was something he loved to do. He was definitely able to express himself through that.
Hopefully that when people listen to this, that they will get, it will speak to them in ways that sometimes we probably don't understand or imagine.
I'm just so excited that people finally get to hear his music and celebrate the beauty of what he was able to create.
It's about to see the light of day and the world will experience this, and it's kind of like this secret that's ready to be shared.